My name is Noelle Breckenridge. I'm 29 years old. I began stretching my ears when I was 15 years old. I was definitely drawn to stretching my ears. Not a whole lot of people were doing it, so it was definitely a unique thing that set people apart. When I first started, my ears were already pierced, so I started with jewelry that was just a little bit bigger. As I needed larger sizes, I got more creative and I would use things around the house, like drinking straws, pen caps, marker caps. At their largest, I stretched my ears to over an inch. My ears are stretched enough that I can get my fingers through them. I enjoyed it when I was younger, but I've definitely outgrown the stretched ears. The hair industry can be awesome because it really does allow more self-expression. But I also found that it was kind of a double-edged sword because I definitely felt some hesitation from people as I first met them to do their hair. I do wear my hair down most of the time to avoid showing my ears. I'd like to be able to wear my hair up. I feel like it should be in the past. These are cute.
Thank you.
I've known Noelle for many years now, and she's my go-to hairstylist. She's the only one I trust.
When did you get gauges?
Well, when I was awesome and 16.
Of course. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I totally understand her wanting to get them fixed, just because as time goes, you know, gravity happens and things are just not as pretty.
Looks great. I love it.
Yeah.
If Dr. Lee was able to fix my ears, it would give me back like the ability to wear my hair the way I want. It's almost like a way of showing I'm a different person and this is a new me.
There's a patient named Noelle coming in today, and I hear she has some issues with her earlobes.
I'm really excited. I am a little bit nervous just because I don't know what the process is really gonna be like.
Hello.
Hi. I have an appointment with Dr. Lee.
Perfect. Can I have you sign in for me?
I'm hoping that Dr. Lee can give me back my earlobes in a way that I can wear normal earrings again and to not feel like I have this old part of me that I've been dragging around.
Are you Noelle?
Yes.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
What are you here for? You look too cute. I don't even see anything going on with you.
I want my earlobes repaired because I had them stretched for a long time and this is as far as they've shrunk.
I love the color of your hair.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, yours were stretched a significant amount. What I look at is see how much earlobe you have left that is salvageable. You know, sometimes it thins it out a little bit.
I know people know me as Dr. Pimple Popper. They really expect me or travel from really far for me to pop their pimples, but I'm pretty darn good at repairing earlobes too. I really like that I can be a part of changing people's lives for the better when they've maybe made a decision in the past that they now regret.
So what you have to do in order to really repair an earlobe that's been stretched is the only way you can get the skin to get back together is to refresh the wound edges. Because then it like sort of it becomes like glue, then it can stick it together. But of course you also want to do that and still make it look like an earlobe, you know, that shape. So that's what we're gonna try to do. We're gonna try to probably try to hide the scar line right along the edge of our ear here. So hold this for me. So what I'm trying to do is it's probably gonna be something like that.
Okay.
I am nervous about what's really possible. Hopefully, my earlobes will look normal again.
All right, let's do that, okay?
Sweet.
It's a tricky procedure to correct stretched earlobes like Noelle's because it's not just a straight side-to-side closure. This is a 3D sort of thing. It's not just a flat surface. You have an earlobe that has a lot of contours and turns to it. I like doing earlobe repair in particular because it's kind of like you have to fits puzzle pieces together, like it's Jenga or Tetris or something, and it really uses your creativity as a surgeon. Part of the earlobe has been stretched away, it's been thinned out, and you still want to, after the repair, make sure it still looks like a legitimate earlobe. Okay. So we're gonna cover you too so that your ear's kind of sticking out. Noelle's got some pretty big gauges. They're challenging because the skin has really been stretched. There's not that much earlobe skin there, so I really have to make use of as much of that skin as possible and try to make this earlobe look as normal as possible.
Make sure nothing ever hurts or bothers you. This is the important move right here. When you do it once, you can't go back.
Noelle is here. She has some really stretched out earlobes. I'm gonna do an earlobe repair, and I really only have one shot. It's not like if you remove skin, you can really just put it back on. Once you take it off, that's it, it's off.
So I'm just trying to refresh the wound edges here, because that's the only way that it can stick back together again.
As Dr. Lee is cutting, it just sounds really loud in my ear. It was a little bit freaky.
I get one chance, so let's do it right.
The very edge of your earlobe, when it heals, it's very hard to get that to be smooth, and that's what people see. When you have an earlobe, you wanna see that contour of it being nice and smooth, but if you sew the edge slightly up or down, it will usually heal, like at least puckered in or puckered out, so you could have like an elf ear, or you could have a big dip in the curve of your earlobe.
All right, I like that. Okay, let's go to the next one. You did great.
Yay.
So I'm gonna turn you a little bit this way again, now this way, good.
The whole challenge here, and why I like the challenge of doing earlobe repair, is to really be able to hide it that she's ever had any stretched earlobes at all. The whole plan in my mind is to be able to, where am I placing the incisions, where am I placing the scar, so that it's the most hidden.
It's actually very fun, in a sense, because it's like creativity, like
patchwork.
How are you gonna fit the, it's like Tetris. It's like Tetris.
Oh, yeah.
It's really hard to make that edge perfect. The best way to do that, interestingly, is to increase the length of the scar and stack it. So the scar, instead of being straight down, is jagged. And that actually, even though the scar is longer, it makes it look better.
That looks dang good, too.
There's always a favorite.
Is this one the favorite?
I like this one, too. I like them both. Here's your little pieces, though, if you want to see that.
Yeah,
you care to see that?
Those little things.
Here's the stretched out.
Weird.
See, this, you can wear this like a ring.
Oh,
an earlobe ring.
That's crazy that it's like just the inside.
Your earlobe's around my finger.
That's crazy.
That's weird. Here's your other earlobe ring.
There we are. I bet we could sell them on eBay. When Dr. Lee put that like loop of skin on her finger, it was really weird. I think it means we bonded, maybe. Oh, that's crazy.
I purposely hide the stitch right here, because if you put a stitch here, it oftentimes will get a little bump. I'm really, really happy with them. They look legit.
Yay!
Yay.
Thank you so much.
No, of course, that was fun.
Yeah.
It was really nice to meet you too, you're lovely.
To see my earlobes new again, I think that it's inspiring. Now I can wear my hair up, so it's nice to be able to leave with a happy ending for my ears and for me.
No one will know that you have them, only you.
Yay! I'm really excited that I have normal earlobes again.